This is a lecture on the information system security. Today we are going to discuss secure hash algorithm in the unit 4. In the previous lecture we have discussed the simple hash algorithm. The secure hash algorithm is one of the example of the simple hash algorithm, and it follows all the properties we have discussed for the simple hash algorithm. So the secure hash algorithm is a family of cryptographic functions which is published by National Institute of Standard and Technology. The secure hash algorithm has four versions, the SHA-0, SHA-1, SHA-2 and SHA-3. The SHA-0 is the first version of the secure hash algorithm. So the SHA-0 was never used practically because it has many weaknesses regarding security. So the next version was the SHA-1, and the SHA-1 is the mostly used version of the SHA. Now we will discuss the working of SHA-1 algorithm. So the SHA-1 gives a message digest of 160 bit in the output. In the SHA-1, we perform the following operation on the input message. The first operation is padding. In the padding, we add zeros and ones on. In the original message, such that the length of the message becomes 64 bit less than exact multiple of 512 bit. In the second step, we append the length of the message, that is the length of the original message, before the padding. In the third step, we divide the input message into blocks of 512 bit. In the next fourth step, we initialize 5 chaining variables, and the size of each chaining variable is of 32 bit. In the fifth step, we perform process block. In the process block, the following operation are performed. So the first, we copy the chaining variable into the corresponding variables denoted by small a, b, c, d and e. In the next step, we divide the block of 512 bit into 16 sub blocks, each block of the 32 bit. Now we perform 4 round on these 16 sub blocks. Each of this round is consist of 20 steps. So we will not go in details that what happens in these 20 steps. We can simply understand it by the following diagram. So this is all about the SHA. The SHA-1 is the most widely used of the existing SHA hash function. So it is employed in several widely used applications and protocols, including the secure socket layer for the security of the SSL. So in 2005, a method was found for uncovering the collisions for SHA-1 within practical time frame, making long-term employability of SHA-1 doubtful. So the next stronger version of SHA come, and it was SHA-2. SHA-2 family has 4 further SHA variants named SHA-224, SHA-256, SHA-384 and SHA-512. These are named depending on their output hash value. So no successful attacks have yet been reported on SHA-2 hash function, but the SHA-2 hash function was similar in the design and the structure as of SHA-1. So the NIST called for new competitive hash function. And so in October 2012, the SHA-3 of the SHA 3 CAM as the newer version of the SHA. So the SHA 3 is if has efficient performance and good resistance for attacks. Next topic is the message authentication code. So the message authentication code is used for the authentication purpose. So basically the authentication is to verify whether the process of verifying that the involved communicating party is the same as it claimed to be. The MAC algorithm is a symmetric key cryptographic technique to provide message authentication. For establishing MAC process, the sender and the receiver share a symmetric key. Essentially, a MAC is an encrypted checksum which is generated on the underlying message that is sent along with a message to ensure message authentication. Now we can understand the detailed process of the MAC by the following diagram. So before start performing the MAC authentication, the sender and the receiver has to share a symmetric key named K. At the sender side, the sender will calculate the MAC of the original message using the MAC algorithm and the secret key K. Now, this calculated MAC will be embedded with the original message and it will be sent to the receiver. Now, on the receiver's side, on receiving the message, the receiver will calculate the MAC of the message received using the MAC algorithm and the key K. So, if the MAC calculated by the receiver and the MAC received with the message matches and both are equal, then the receiver will accept the message. But if the MAC does not matches, then in that case, the two possibilities are there. Either the message was altered in between the transmission, or the sender of the message is false. So in this case, it is very difficult to determine for the receiver that what happened with the original message. So the receiver will not consider this message as the genuine message and it will not accept this message. Now, what are the limitations of MAC? There are two major limitations of MAC. Both limitations are due to its symmetric nature. So, the first limitation is establishment of shared secret. So, it can provide message authentication among pre-decided legitimate users who have shared key. This requires establishment of shared secret prior to use of MAC. The second limitation is inability to provide non-repudiation. Non-repudiation is the assurance that a message originator cannot deny any previously sent message and commitments or actions. So MAC technique does not provide a non-repudiation service. If the sender and the receiver get involved in a dispute over message origination, MAC cannot provide a proof that a message was indeed sent by the sender. Though no third party can compute the MAC, still sender could deny having sent the message and claim that the receiver forged it, as it is impossible to determine which of the two parties compute the MAC. So, to overcome this limitation of non-repudiation, another method called as digital signature can be used. So digital signature uses the concept of asymmetric encryption, or we can say public key cryptography. We will discuss this topic in the next lecture. Thank you.